All right, so we have our we're excited. I'm sorry that the other video kind of cut me off a little. In this video, we're going to talk about in-text citations. So what's on the other side of this? Before I get to that, just a real quick review. The works cited is only the sources that you're actually citing in the paper. They need to be alphabetized. So we have the B before the O in this case. They need to include a date accessed if they were found online. So you'll notice that the one for the book does not have this. We don't need that for print sources because they are printed. They will never change. Online sources change all the time. So we need an access date for them so that we know that the last version that you saw, and you're protected in the event that that website goes and alters anything in the article or changes anything. It doesn't look like you miscited it. We can see that those changes were made after the last date that you visited. How do we text or text? How do we cite in the text? Okay, so MLA kind of works like footnotes, honestly. It's just instead of using numbers, we use words. So we use the first piece of information that is available to us, which 9 times out of 10 is going to be the author information. Okay, so what does an in-text citation look like? Well, you actually have some choices. You can say this word in the sentence, or you can say it in a parenthetical. So a parenthetical looks like this. So Bernstein, and there's no page numbers. This was an online source with no page numbers. So that's it. That's what it looks like. For the other one, I actually have two authors, so I want to use both of their last names, Owen and Sahil. However, this is a print source, so my quote came from a page number. I do not need to put any kind of abbreviation to show that it's a page number. So let's just say that it came from page 320. That's what it looks like. And it is that simple. You want the information to show which source on the works cited page it came from, and you do that by using the first piece of information that is available to you. I'm going to kind of copy one of these so I can show you what to do if you don't have author information. And this is what I mean by it's the first piece of information available to us. So oftentimes that is the author, but occasionally you have something that doesn't have an author. So then you have to work with this title, this source title information. You do not need to include the whole thing, but you do need to show that it's a title. So I'm going to put quotes on it, and I'm just going to call it 10 tips. And again, I don't have a page number or anything. So, I don't need to put anything here. However, say I want to be really helpful to my readers, and maybe it's kind of a long article, and they've numbered the paragraphs, or I went and I counted the paragraphs. If I want to include a paragraph number, I can choose to do that. Again, it is 100% optional and up to you. But if you decide to include a paragraph number, you can put a P for paragraph, and then whatever that paragraph number is. Can have a period there or not. There it goes. Now, parentheticals go at the end of the sentence after the quote. You have, again, several options for how you actually want to include this in your sentence. So this information can happen in a parenthetical, out of a parenthetical, or in both. And again, it's what source did you use and where was the quote inside the source if we have a way of numbering that. So let's say that I'm talking about a specific fact where not, let's just say not everyone really wants to go to college due based, sorry, based on a number of recent California studies. I'm completely making this up. I just need a sentence to work with. So choice number one, Owen and Sahil, 320. Choice number two, maybe I say the author's names, but not the page number. So I say, according to Owen and Sahil, and I'm using a paraphrase, not a quote. Not everyone wants to go to college because of number of recent Califord studies. Okay. And I have the page number here. I could also say, on page 320, Owen and Sahil explain that not everyone wants to go to college, and then I delete the page number off the end, and all of these are correct. Any of these are correct. If I have a quote, maybe they say, maybe what they really said, let's just say, was, because the lessons there don't necessarily help them in a specific career choice. And let's say that that's their words. Then obviously you need to have quotes. If I am choosing to use the parentheticals, then they go after the quote, but before the period. And the reason for that is because the citation is part of my sentence as the writer. I have added that citation to my sentence, so it goes before the period, but it is not part of the quote. The author I'm quoting didn't have a citation to themselves, so I cannot put it inside the quotes because they didn't say it. So this is where it lives, between the quote and the period. If you want to quote something in the middle of a sentence, the citation still goes at the end of the sentence, unless for some reason what follows after is from another source or disagrees with what the cited source was saying. So this happens sometimes. It might happen in your comparison papers, where maybe you are doing something along the lines of this, where you say not everyone really wants to go to college because the lessons learned there don't necessarily help them in a specific career choice, but some people go anyway, oops, I scroll down so you can see that, because, and then let's pull another, I'm going to make another fake quote, but because they feel it helps them become more well-rounded. And let's say that that quote is coming from a different source. That's the only reason that you would see a citation in the middle, is if you're citing two sources in one sentence. Otherwise, the citation goes at the end. And that's pretty much all you really need for in-text citation right now for this essay. There are a few other things that we can talk about in terms of this location. Oftentimes the location is a page number, or it's nothing because nothing was provided for you. Some people, by preference, not requirement, like to count paragraph numbers. So again, that's 100% optional. If you're citing a video, you're going to put the runtime. If you're citing a poem, you're going to put the lines. If you're citing a really, really, really old book like Mary Shelley's Frankenstein that there's just thousands of versions and copies of, you can choose to cite the chapter as opposed to the page number so that they don't have to find the exact version you are using. So there's a lot of options in terms of what we can put for where the quote is. But for essay, one, that what you're looking at is you're going to either be citing the page number because you're citing the article from the book, or you're not going to be citing anything at all because it's an online article, or you might be using a page number because you pulled an article from a database, and so it was originally a print source, so you have access to the page numbers, Or you are going to voluntarily be counting the paragraph numbers for an online source, which again is optional. You don't have to do. That's it. And then reading the sentence, I know, like, hey, I want to know more about these Owen and Sawhill people. And then I can go to your Works Cited and I can find them because they're alphabetized. And I can say, okay, that's the book. That's the place I need to go if I want to read this article in its entirety for myself. If you have any questions, you know what to do.